Sing that in the bus, though.
Let the fucking show begin.
Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to show you how to snatch a man in the zombie apocalypse when that's the only plot that the writers give you. First off, I've pulled my hair up already for the wig, and now I'm just kind of getting it situated where I can do my makeup. Photo focus primer is first. I'm just going to put this all over my face just to keep my makeup on all day. Next, I am going to be contouring with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Stick in the shade Contour Original. This is kind of one of the more complex parts of the routine because I'm kind of trying to emulate Katelyn Nacon's facial shape, which is very difficult. She has just a gorgeous facial shape and really nice bone structure, and I have the face of a potato. So it's kind of hard for me to get that kind of look to make us look kind of similar-ish. So I'm just going about making my forehead look smaller and my jawline looking a little bit more chiseled. I don't contour my nose because she has kind of a broader set nose, so I don't do that, obviously. On the normal day-to-day I do, but not now. And I am going to take the contour all the way back to, like, my ear, right at the, like, cut of my cheekbone. Once that's all on, I'm just going to blend it out. I'm sorry that this didn't go in fast motion because I just wanted to show y'all exactly what I did, because that is kind of the big part of it. And now it's in fast motion. Okay, next I'm going to use the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Stick Foundation, yeah, in the shade Shell Ivory. I love this foundation. I love the original in the bottle, but I love the stick more. It's great. I'm going to put this over the contour that I've already put on. That gives it a more natural look, where if you just have contour on top of your foundation, it looks a little bit more snatched. As snatched as we want to look, it's not exactly appropriate for the look I'm going for. Then I'm just going to blend that out with that Wet n Wild Beauty sponge again. Okay, then I'm going to just add some more contour to the places where it really needs to be chiseled and blend that out. This is just to add more definition. Why do I make such weird faces when I'm doing my makeup? That's so freaking obnoxious. Ugh. Okay, then I'm going to use the Bare Minerals Concealer. It's my favorite concealer, and I'm just going to conceal just some random zits on my face and under my eyes. Caitlyn's skin is perfect, and that's the only reason I did go back over and conceal, because she has really nice skin, and normally you wouldn't, but I also look like a corpse with my freaking under eye circles, and not to, you know, be a spoiler, but I mean, my head ain't going on the pike yet, so. Okay, then I'm just going to set random places on my face with the Anastasia contour kit in whatever that light powdery shade is. Yeah, that. Okay, now I'm actually setting my face with the Super Goop powder. It's just the SPF Invincible setting powder. You have to like turn it and shake it to get the product to come out. It makes a mess, as you can see. And then I'm just gonna set wherever I need setting. Alright, now I'm going to use the Glossier Cloud Paint in Dusk, and I'm just going to add a little bit of flush to my cheeks because, again, our heads hadn't been cut off yet. We still got blood flow, so let's show that off while we can. Because as soon as the writers are done having us mac on Alden, we're going to lose that. Now I'm going to use the two brow gels on my eyebrows. I use two brow gels on my eyebrows every single day. This is basically just my everyday brow routine. It's kind of minimal effort and it works. I go through with the light one first and then I go back to add some definition with the dark one. But this is the light one that you're seeing right now. You can just see the disgust on my face as I try to figure out if my eyebrows look like that. All right, Marc Jacobs primer for my eyes. I don't even know why I did eyeshadow, but I think I just was doing it to where it would even out the colors on my eyelids. I'm gonna put that same light shade from the contour kit all over my eyelid. And then I'm going to go back through with another color in a second. Okay, now I'm going to go in with the Lime Crimes Plushies palette. I love these palettes. They're so cute, and they work so well. I'm going to go in with, I think that's Mango. No, it's not Mango. I don't remember what it is. I'm sorry. But put that in the crease. And that's just for definition for photography purposes. It's not really anything related to the character or, you know, how I think they do her makeup on set. It's literally just for definition for photography. Okay, now I'm going to use the Maybelline Total Temptation mascara in brown. I think I was looking to see if the color's on there, but it's not. I'm going to just kind of define my lashes with it. I'm not going to go real, real hard in it. If you've seen any of my Instagram pictures, you know I like a really heavy, full-looking eyelash. But I'm just trying to make them defined and kind of natural-looking. Okay, am I done? No. Okay, I'm putting on lipstick. This is just kind of a natural color, and I'm going to blot it out. I don't even know what color it is. It's from LA Colors. It's like you can get it at the drugstore, Dollar General, that sort of thing. I would have liked to fill in my lips more because she has really, really full lips, but I couldn't find my lip liner, so whatever. It is what it is. Now I'm going to set it with the Make It Last setting spray. Make your makeup last even while the whispers are cutting your head off. Now I'm going to remove my ear piercings because she only has two, so I'm going to switch mine around. I have the heart earrings that she wore on like her first few seasons coming to me in the mail for Walker Stalker, but they're not here yet, so I just kind of improvise. I can't remember if she has one or two ear piercings. Either way, it's coming out. Transition, so cool. Now you're gonna put on the wig cap and adjust it as necessary. This is the best wig cap application that I have done since trying to put this wig on to perfect this cosplay. So God bless. Everybody leave a comment and congratulate me on figuring out the wig cap. Oh my God, the clock in my house. Shut up. Anyway, alpha who? I'm bald as hell. Now we're going to put the wig actually on, if the clock will ever shut up, there. This wig is so soft. It came from Wish. It looks hella bad right there because I haven't brushed it out and gotten it worked out yet, but it looks fairly decent. It's also really soft, and I'm going to just brush it and mess with the wig for the next literally like 15 seconds of this video. Also, not to pat myself on the back, but that eyebrow shade is literally like perfect for this wig. Alright, and that's about it. Here's some awkward mirror shots of me in this full cosplay. There's pictures on my Instagram, at fairlyshelby, if you want to check that out. And if you're going to Walker Stalker Atlanta, leave me a comment. Bye!